वेलकम बैक माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स. सिल्क रोड बाय निक मिडलटन पार्ट टू. सो वी हैव डन अप टू नाउ इंट्रोडक्शन एंड समरी पार्ट एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट एक्सप्लेनेशन पार्ट. सो हियर यू कैन सी द टेक्स्ट एंड इन रेड कलर द hard words with their meanings are already written. You can read and I'm going to explain it line by line. As the protagonist, here protagonist means the author who was a part of this story. So he was heading towards Mount Kailas to complete the Kora in the morning. He witnessed a beautiful half moon in the blue sky. The clouds looked like French bread, which glowed pink because of the sun, which spread a slash of rays on the mountain tops. It looked like a rose tinted blush. Rahu and Lamo wanted to give him a farewell gift. One evening when he passed a message to Lamo through Daniel, she gave him a long-sleeved sheepskin coat which is meant for men. Satan looked at him attentively while he climbed into his car. He declared yes and said Drokba to him, which means Kora in the region of Tibet. They took a shortcut to cut off the Chantang. His driver knew the short route, which took them to the southwest towards Mount Kailas. They had to pass high mountain passes. Satan told him that they can reach the destination only if there is no snow, and they cannot say that until they will reach there. Next paragraph. The route was filled with open plains in Rahu, where gazelles were eating grass from the land, which had little rain, and this approved while hopping back in the void. As they moved forward, a large group of wild asses appeared. Satan told him that they were approaching the wild asses long before they appeared there. Satan pointed out a huge pile of dust, which he called Kiang in his local language. When they drew nearer to the destination, they could see a large group of animals progressing in a fast and uncontrollable manner, like they were doing military exercise. Trails of dust filled with air. Next paragraph. The hard words are given below in red color. And now it's time to explain. As they move past the rocky area, they came across private koras nurturing their group of birds. Both men and women stared at their car, and some also waved at them. As they moved closer to the animals, the sheep would take a slippery path and would suddenly move into another direction away from the car. They witnessed nomads' tents, which were dark in complete isolation, and a big black Tibetan dog standing as their guard. They fixed their gaze on the approaching car and ran behind it as a bullet fired from a gun. Next paragraph. Those bushy creatures were blacker than the normal black color, who wore a bright red collar, and they barked angrily at them with big jaws. Those dogs were fearless and were running towards the car, causing Satan to apply brakes and change direction suddenly. The dogs ran after them for 100 meters more and then stopped to watch them go away. These Tibetan Mastiffs became popular in China's royal courts as hunting dogs. They were brought along the Silk Route as tribute in ancient times from Tibet. As they passed the area with bushy Tibetan dogs, they started witnessing snow-capped mountains. They entered the valley, which was covered with wide river, covered with ice, which was white and shiny in the sun. The track was moving along the river bank as they gained height, and the valley was closing in towards them. Next paragraph. Explanation. The driver was driving in third gear while the turns were sharper and the ride got bumpier. Then they moved away from the road, which ran along the icy river. It had sharp slopes and big rocks coated with thick, sticky orange lichen. Below the rocks were chunks of snow. The protagonist felt a pressure on his ears. He held his nose and snorted in order to clear them. A sharp turn came again, and Chetan stopped the car and jumped out from his seat. Daniel too did the same. He exclaimed snow in his excitement. A long track of snow was in front of them, which was about 15 meters long before it diminished and the normal dirty track appeared again. The snow was on both sides of them, and it was difficult to move the vehicle in that condition. The protagonist joined Daniel as Satan tried to move smoothly over the snowy surface by stamping his foot on the surface. The protagonist saw his wristwatch. They were 5,210 meters above sea level. Next paragraph. The snow was deep beneath its icy top surface. Daniel said that if they turned their car over, they could slip off. Satan grabbed dirt and threw it across the frozen surface. They pitched in and helped Satan until the snow with soil appeared and it loaded the tension of Satan. He drove back the car and slowly drove to the more comfortable side of the road. After 10 minutes, Satan stopped again as another obstacle came in front of them. They drove around the snowy track, which was sleek, which was steep and filled with rocks. He further drove from the hairpin bend, moving on the higher side where the snow was still there. So now it's time to say thank you. Thank you for watching Silk Road Part